Well, I guess if somebody asked me what Gay City is, what Gay City does, at the heart of who we are is doing what's best and what's right for gay and bisexual men.
Gay City Health Project was the first organization in the country that was founded out of the vision and the values of the gay men's health movement.
A group of local community activists and public health activists got together. Were very dissatisfied with what was happening with HIV prevention in Seattle and decided they needed something different. For the first 6 years or so of the organization, that was the focus, was bold, kind of splashy, big media campaigns, social marketing campaigns, big events and forums, fun stuff. I mean, it was about community building.
Just as building community was of primary importance in the beginning for Gay City, it remains the same today. We are about building community among gay, bi, and trans men, and over the years we've developed all kinds of programs through which we can do that.
So at Gay City, we recognize that every gay man is different. So what we try to do is meet them where they're at and to meet as many of their needs as possible with our programming. So that's their physical needs, their spiritual needs, their emotional needs.
It's basically a day of learning. Classes range from container planting to cooking classes. It's also dancing, line dancing. It's a really unique day for members of the community to come together and be taught by other peers. It's a peer recovery network. It's unique by providing alcohol, drug, and free social events. Volunteers are definitely what keeps us going.
This is my third attempt at quitting smoking. It is a structured weekly commitment that I have with my fellow peers in the Out to Quit program.
Gay City Testing is a very unique an opportunity to engage with our community and offer a service in a confidential, anonymous, and free way to our clients.
Innovative is personal, cutting edge.
So the HIV testing was the important component of that for us, because it was a way for us to continue to live our mission of creating a space for each other to be nurtured and cared for.
Before Gay City and before I was tested, I really wasn't involved in the gay community other than going out to the bars, dancing, partying, and having fun.
I didn't feel any judgment when I came here and got my results. The guy that gave me my results back, and you know, he basically kind of calmed me down. And after that, when we came back into the office, he gave me the resources that I need to take the next step, because honestly, I didn't know what to do.
The questions that he asked me, I never had really been asked before by anybody. So it really made me think hard about where I've come from.
I like what Gay City does. It's like it sort of gets more to the core of what being gay is. And it's like, you're just another person. And It's like, what can we do also? I mean, with the mission statement, even, it's like, you know, how we can prevent people becoming HIV positive. And it's like giving them good core values and helping them, nurture self-esteem.
He was very relaxing, and he really just his whole demeanor encouraged me and relaxed me to talk about myself and the experiences that I had very spontaneously.
I've been involved with Gay City and Giving for about 10 years now. The bulk of the money goes back actually towards the programs they do. And I mean, they really are consistent with that.
Everything we do comes from that place of what's good for the community, what's good for gay guys, what's good for bi guys, trans guys.
I decided to get back into yoga, practicing. And one thing led to another, and then I'm going to start teaching again. And then with that came opening a yoga studio. And all of this comes back to Gay City because the yoga studio is for men.
I like the fact that it's more comprehensive. It's not just one cause. It's more dealing with the day-to-day trials, tribulations, things that gay men deal with. A place where they can get anything from AIDS testing to smoking cessation to support for meth habits. It's just a lot of stuff that they cover versus just one.
It's very life-changing, and it's a really good feeling to know that we have a place like this in our area, in our community. This is the place that saved my life.
All of these lines across my face tell you the story of who I am. So many stories of where I've been, and now I got to where I am. But these stories don't mean you've got no one to tell them to. It's true, I was made for you.